In one of the great mysteries of aviation, pilot Fred Valentich and his Cessna aircraft disappeared from the face of the Earth. In his last moments, he had an encounter with something no one can explain.
It is hovering on top of me again, and it's not an aircraft.
I every now and then think about what could have happened, and I still draw to the same conclusion. I just don't know.
On that fateful day, Fred was just 20 years old, with ambitions to become a commercial pilot.
That was his whole passion of flying. He loved it. The last years of his life, that's all he did. He dedicated everything to flying.
October the 21st, 1978. At 6:20 p.m., Fred climbed aboard a rented Cessna 182 single-engine plane for a routine flight. A common occurrence in a vast country where light aircraft are a common form of transportation. The plan was to pick up an order of crayfish. The flight should have taken just over an hour. Conditions were good, visibility was clear, and the plane was regularly serviced. His planned route took him over the outskirts of Melbourne, past Cape Otway, to King Island in the Bass Strait. Initially, the flight seemed normal, as Fred spoke to Melbourne Flight Service Officer Steve Roby.
Well, he just made a standard position report over Cape Otway with an estimate for King Island. I think he said he was operating below 5,000, and that was it.
45 minutes into the flight, there began an extraordinary exchange. Steve Roby was the last person to speak to Fred. To this day, he's still shaken by the memory. This is a transcript of the beginning of their remarkable conversation.
Frederick said, "Melbourne, this is Delta Sierra Juliet. Is there any known traffic below 5,000? I said,
"Delta Sierra Juliet, no known traffic.
It seems to me there's a large aircraft below 5,000.
I got him to describe the aircraft. It is four bright, it seems to me like landing lights. Then he said, "The aircraft has just passed over me at least 1,000 feet above." He was describing it doing some fairly strange things.
"Delta Sierra Juliet, it seems to me that he's playing some sort of game.
He's flying over me two, three times at speeds I could not identify."
Steve Roby can recall Fred's fear as if it was yesterday.
Just listening to him, I can still remember it distinctly. The way he was speaking to me in a broken communication, a form of hesitant communication, he definitely sounded as if he was under stress. And I could just picture him sort of in the aircraft looking around for this object in the sky.
"Delta Sierra Juliet, Melbourne, come in, over."
4 minutes later, the radio went dead.
"Delta Sierra Juliet, Melbourne, come in, over."
Fred never arrived at King Island. This is the first time Richard Valentich, Fred's younger brother, has agreed to speak in an interview.
"My mum came in and she was crying and she said, 'Fred's been in an accident.'"
Immediately, a search and rescue mission was launched. Aircraft were scrambled, search teams combed the shore, and ships crisscrossed the ocean.
Most of that day, I remember the news reports saying that they were searching for a pilot that had ditched into the sea.
No trace of Fred or his plane was ever found.
I cried for 3 days. I think I'd never stop crying. It really gutted me that he disappeared. You know, it was a big hole in my life.
Investigator George Simpson has felt a lifelong connection with this story since a chance sighting when he was a boy.
I've always felt that I was one of the last people to see the plane in the air.
Just came out here one evening. I was waiting for my girlfriend who was coming over for dinner. And it was just gone to 6 o'clock and she was a little bit late. And I just came out here to the post here and to wait for her. And I saw a plane flying over. It was a Cessna. I remember the angle that was on exactly. And if you look at a map and you check that angle, that's directly to Cape Otway.
I've thought for years that it's a mystery that needs solving.
Now he wants to answer the questions surrounding the disappearance of Fred Valentich once and for all. Could the lights Fred reported be a clue?
It's full bright. It seems to be like landing lights.